بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We'll continue إن شاء الله in episode 23. إن شاء الله this is episode 23. سبحان الله, time is going too fast. جزء 24 إن شاء الله تعالى. The جزء 24 comes in the second half of سورة الزمر, and then we're gonna cover سورة غافر إن شاء الله, and most of Surat Fussilat, most of Surat Fussilat, or Hamim al-Sajda. This is one of the names of Surat Fussilat. If you remember, the name of Surat Az-Zumar comes from the Zumara, an incident, there is a section at the end of Surat Az-Zumar where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes to us that on the day of Qiyamah, people will be the people of Jannah, the groups of Jannah, the troops of Jannah will be driven into Jannah, and the groups of the fire of Jahannam will be driven into the fire of Jahannam, wal-iyadu billah. So it seems that this is one of the major themes of Surah Az-Zumar, and that's why the name is given. The juz begins from the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ فَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مَنْ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا أَوْ كَذَّبَ بِالصِّدْقِ إِذْ جَاءَهُ, which means who can be more wicked than, or more oppressor, you know, or wrongdoing than a person who invents a lie against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Az-Zumar emphasizes and stresses upon the value or the cornerstone of believe in Allah, which is Tawheed, Al-Tawheed Al-Khalis, Ala Lillahi Deen Al-Khalis. That's why the surah, you know, stresses upon this and spells out a details about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's divinity and being worthy of worship, some of his ayat subhanahu wa ta'ala in his creation. Allah says, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِكَافٍ عَبِدًا, isn't Allah sufficient for his slave or her slave? Bala, certainly. When Allah says, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِكَافٍ عَبِدًا, we should say, Bala. Bala kaf, Allah is sufficient for us. Don't ask any other than Allah. Don't invoke other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah also says, if Allah intends to harm you, no one can save you. And if He intends to bestow blessings upon you, no one can withhold these blessings from you. وَإِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُ. If you are in a dhur, in a adversity, or in sickness, or whatever, you know, you need to connect your heart and attach your heart to Allah and invoke Him. There is something here, the Surah Az-Zumar speaks about, subhanAllah, a reality that even scientifically it was also reflected upon with regard to the lesser form of sleep, which is death, which is sleep. So sleep is a lesser form of death. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions here that it is He who recalls the souls of people upon their death and the living people during their sleep. So Allah controls our souls. Every single day and or the night when we go to sleep, when we go to bed, our souls, you know, are being like called or recalled by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and kept with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is said that the souls, subhanAllah, go or leave the body, you know, go to somewhere in heavens. Allah knows best, you know, some, you know, reflections about this. And then when a person wakes up, the ruh revisits again. And that's why, subhanAllah, when we wake up, we say, Alhamdulillah, الذي أحيانا بعدما أماتنا وإليه النشور. All praises are due to Allah who gave us life after we have been dead, and to whom is our resurrection. So, Allah يتوفى الأنفس حين موتها. This is the ayah. Briefly or swiftly, I'm gonna list to you the main contents of this juz, inshallah, and then I will elaborate a little bit on some verses. Allah mentions here that if the wrongdoers possess all the treasures of this earth and much more beside that, they will, in the day of Qiyamah, will offer, they would wish to offer these treasures of the entire, you know, dunya to redeem and to save themselves, to be granted salvation from the fire of Jahannam on the day of judgment. Subhanallah. The entire dunya, you know, the treasures of the whole earth, you know, will not be sufficient to save or ransom a person from the punishment of Allah. وَلَوْ أَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا وَمِثْلَهُ مَعَهُ لَفْتَدَوْ بِهِ. Those who transgressed against their souls, they shouldn't despair in Allah's mercy. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls out, Allah invites His slaves, His servants, and Allah calls, Allah names them as transgressors. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means to invite us and to invite those who are doing sin. So the scholar, some of the sahaba, they say, أَرْجَى آيَةٌ فِي الْقُرْآنِ. This is the most hopeful, or the ayah, the best ayah of hope in the Quran. Arja ayah min fi al-Quran. The most powerful ayah that gives you hope and raja in Allah's mercy is قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. And subhanAllah, Allah speaks to us about the tawbah and the value if you turn to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he is willing to forgive us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So no one is allowed to despair in the rahmah of Allah. إِنَّهُ لَيَأْسِوا مِنْ رَحْمِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرُونَ. Only the unbelievers are the ones who despair and are hopeless in the mercy of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This, of course, opens the doors of repentance and ask Allah forgiveness and turning back to Allah, fixing and rectifying our behaviors and conducts with regard to our deen. It does not open the doors, you know, to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying and assuming Allah is forgiver, Allah forgives, and then we do the wrong things. No, it doesn't say that. The ayah opens doors of mercy and rahmah for those who seem hopeless. Wal'iyadu billah. So the ayat from 53 up to 63 are speaking about this amazing bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concludes the surah Al-Zumar with a scene that is being depicted subhanallah powerfully and eloquently. Subhanallah, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَأَشْرَقَتُ الْأَرْضُ بِنُورِ رَبِّهَا. The earth will be illuminated by the light of its Lord, and وَجِئَ بِالنَّبِيِّينَ, the prophets will be brought and gathered, وَفِيَتْ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا عَمِلَتْ, and every soul will be fulfilled, you know, with regard to their actions and deeds, good or bad. And then وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, those who disbelieved, they will be driven into fire, and those who had taqwa, they will be driven into Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the min alladhina, from those who would be driven into the Jannah. Subhanallah, recently, just a couple of months ago, so an Egyptian imam, subhanallah, he was reading this ayah, wasiqa alladhina attaqaw rabbahum ila aljannati zumara in salat al-fajr, and he died. Subhanallah, the video is on YouTube, subhanallah, very inspirational and emotional, subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all husn khatima, ameen. Surah Ghafir, the surah that comes next, it's named after Ghafir, Allah himself is Ghafir, and subhanallah, beautiful, it's so beautiful to reflect how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes himself in the Quran. Allah says that he is Ghafur, right, and he is Ghaffar, and he is Ghafir. Subhanallah, the different forms of and deviations of the word forgiveness. So he is the oft forgiving, he is the extremely forgiver, he is the entirely, and comprehensively and extensively forgiver, and he is the forgiver, he al-ghafur, al-ghaffar, al-ghafir. So the surah begins with describing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as ghafir al-dhanb. In the same time, Allah says, وَقَابِلِ التَّوْبِ شَدِيدِ الْعِقَابِ. He is also, his punishment is severe. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from his punishment. So we have to be balanced and living and benefiting by the method of the Quran when he gives targhib and tarheeb, warning and admonishment, encouragement and warning. So that's how the Quran works, and that's how we live the human being to thrive and be successful. We have to fear from what cause us, destruction and what is dangerous against us. And we have to hope, the two wings of the birds, hope and fear. So, and the head of the bird is love. So these are the three wings and the three cornerstones for a believer to succeed in this dunya. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the tawfiq. Surah Ghafir, another name for Surah Ghafir is Al-Mu'min. Why? Al-Mu'min, referring to the believer. Mu'min Ali Fir'aun. Because there is a lengthy section about Mu'min Ali Fir'aun. And that was a person from the relatives of Fir'aun, the family of Fir'aun. He was hiding his iman. And then, subhanAllah, he spoke up, subhanAllah, when he found Sayyidina Musa was, people were going to kill Sayyidina Musa, alayhi salam, and he was defending him. And he was inviting people through eloquent, method of da'wah, to believe in Allah. So he was using different methods of emotional, logical, sometimes he was little bit, serious, was little bit, emotional to the people. And it's full of lessons of da'wah. It is said that the wife of this person, Mu'min Ali Fir'aun, وَجَاءَ رَجُلٌ مِّنْ آلِ فِرْعَوْنَ يَكْتُمُ إِيمَانَهُ. He was hiding his faith. It is said that his wife was the hairdresser of the daughters of Fir'aun. So, subhanAllah, from the palace of Fir'aun, we have got the wife of Fir'aun, and, the Mu'min Ali Fir'aun, a couple of people believed, subhanAllah, ajib, Allah can save you, or can save a person, and can grant his mercy, even if a person is in the room of oppression or darkness, or where people are, living within, a very, evil or kind of people, such people who are disobeying Allah, meaning the rahmah of Allah can reach anyone if, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, and it depends also on people's, wishing to seek guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the surah begins with saying a reality. مَا يُجَادِلُ فِي آيَاتِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. خلاص. No one disputes the revelations of Allah except the unbelievers. Done. If you find someone today is arguing, if someone is questioning, what is the Quran? What are the miracles of the Quran? How the Quran was revealed? This is actually required. The Islam invites us to make questions, to raise questions and reflect. But if someone is debating, arguing about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revelation, about the Quran, right? So they are unbelievers. And they are unbelievers. The Quran says that. Then we have got in Surah Ghafir, subhanAllah, something that is beautiful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the virtue of those who make tawbah. Allah mentions that the angels ask Allah forgiveness for them. SubhanAllah, we go to bed and you are sleeping and the angels are making dua for you and ask Allah forgiveness for you. Why? When you make sincere tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the surah speaks about, subhanAllah, depicts a very, very powerful, something that is really, really is worthy of our reflection, and it has stern and powerful warnings about the day of Qiyamah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ. To whom his kingdom is today, right? And لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَارِ. Allah speaks about that. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who denied the prophets and Allah's revelations were all destroyed. And then we have got the story of Sayyidina Musa and the story of Sayyidina Musa being sent to Fir'aun, Haman and Qarun, and then the excellent speech of Mu'min Ali Fir'aun. And then the speech continued to remind people about life and the hereafter. إنما الحياة الدنيا متاع وإن الآخرة هي دار القرار. To speak about Jannah, to speak about hell, still the speech of Mu'min Ali Fir'aun. And then the speech continued to speak about shirk. ويا قوم ما لي أدعوكم إلى النجاة وتدعونني إلى النار تدعونني لأكفر بالله وأشرك به ما ليس لي به علم وأنا أدعوكم إلى العزيز الغفار. سبحان الله, beautiful about some methods of da'wah. how to invite people to the deen of Allah and to tawheed and to warn them from shirk. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ Allah mentions here, إِنَّا لَنَنصُرُ رُسُلَنَا وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا Allah says, Allah does not help, Allah does not only help His prophets and messengers and the followers of His guidance, not only in this dunya, not only in the akhirah, but also in this dunya. إِنَّا لَنَنصُرُ رُسُلَنَا وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ Allah will give victory and support. Allah will take revenge, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give power, you know, and support to those who believed in this dunya and in the hereafter. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions an ayah, beautiful ayah. Subhanallah. Allah says, لَخَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ أَكْبَرُ مِنْ خَلْقِ النَّاسِ Indeed, the creation of the heavens and earth is much greater than the creation of a human being. What is a human being, you know, what is your size, what is your, you know, how, what are you, you know, a human being compared to this magnificent, you know, dominion of Allah. We are in the earth, you know, one of the, we are in a planet of earth. How the earth is, you know, compared to the sun, for example. You know, the earth is one of, you know, millions of galaxies are there, subhanallah, and the universe is expanding. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَخَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ The creation of heavens and earth is greater than the creation of a human being. Even though the creation of a human being is still something that is mind-blowing, sophisticated, subhanallah, but it is nothing compared to the creation of the heavens and earth. And actually, this ayah is actually intriguing me to study, go a little bit and study about astronomy. I mean, I'm passionate about this as well. The main reason is to reflect on the ayat of the Quran. I'm inviting everyone, you know, all of the Muslim students to study, try to study science, you know, study as much as you could of dunya sciences so that you can, you know, you can reflect on the Quran. And the Quran is advanced. It is, you know, is advancing all of the of this worldly, you know, materialistic, you know, sciences. Sallallahu ala Rasulillah says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah says here, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ يَدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ You Lord says, and said, invoke me and supplicate to me or pray to me, I will respond to you. Allah says, idعوني, I will أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ Subhanallah, khalas. And this is ayah 51 and 60, subhanallah, the ayah of dua. And then subhanallah, this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that those who argue about the revelation of Allah, فَسَوْفَ يَعْلَمُونَ They will know and they will find the truth in the day of Qiyamah. This Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concludes Surah Ghafir. We're speaking about some of his signs in his creation. Allah says, وَإِنَّ لَكُمْ فِي الْأَنْعَامِ لَعِبْرَةً The cattle, the animals are signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for people of understanding. You have benefits from these cattle. You eat their flesh, and they carry you. They can be used for convenience. Subhanallah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions his punishment for those who disbelieve. By the way, before I begin Surah Fussilat, and Surah Fussilat begins with Hamim. This is the last part in this juz 24 in the Quran. Briefly, I will, inshallah, give you a summary of this Surah Fussilat. Surah Fussilat is the second surah that begins with Hamim. So we have got Surah Ghafir begin with Hamim, Surah Fussilat Hamim, Surah Ashura Hamim, Surah Az-Zukhruf Hamim, Surah Ad-Dukhan Hamim, Surah Al-Ahqaf Al-Jathiyah Hamim, Surah Al-Ahqaf Hamim. Seven surahs, they begin with Hamim. So something I want to share that is common within these all surahs, inshallah. Whenever you read Surah Hamim, you will you remember that. So all of these seven surahs that begin with Hamim, this Hamim, Huruf Muqatta'a, one of 29 letters in the Quran, they are miraculous, you know, words from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So some minutes, Mufassirin, they say we don't know exactly the meaning, but they do have meaning. They do have wisdom, right? So all of these seven surahs are Makkiyan, the revealed in Mecca or revealed before Hijrah. Number two, these surahs have corner stones and have, you know, main objectives behind. You will find in these surahs, Allah speaks about the story of Sayyidina Musa to Fir'aun, right? And you'll find in these surahs, Allah begins immediately after Hamim, Allah speaks about Quran. Tanzilul Kitab, this is the revelation of the book. Allah says, Wal Kitab al Mubin, and the book of clarity. So Allah speaks about the value of the Quran. Number three, Allah speaks about the danger and the evil of disunity and division in the deen, in Tawheed. Allah speaks about that. ثم جعلناك على شريعة من الأمر فاتبعها ولا تتبع أهواء الذين لا يعلمون شرع لكم من الدين ما وصاكم به ولا تتفرقوا فيه. Don't divide in the deen. Don't become into sects. Follow Quran and Sunnah. You know, follow the mainstream Islam. And then another major theme in these surahs, which is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala transferred the message and the guidance or the revelation from the people of the Bani Israel, the children of Israel, to the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, final nation. So any nation actually that came after the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, was sent, is related as under the ummah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And they are of two categories. A category of the Prophet Muhammad ummah who answered the da'wah, and they are the Muslims. And the other category, the ummah al-ijaba and the ummah al-da'wah. Those who answered and those who are still, you know, for and still deserve da'wah to the ummah of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. And the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam message reinforces and completes or perfects all of the previous messages of revelation from Allah. It adds and it matches, it completes these revelations. So these are cornerstones, these are common objectives when you read these seven surahs of Hamim. Enjoy having that reflection. Surah Fussilat, I will conclude inshallah. Surah Fussilat, you remember the Surah Fussilat has an incident. It was revealed in Mecca early. And the mushrikeen, they tried all the means to stop the Prophet Muhammad from the da'wah to Islam. They came to negotiate with him. Oh Muhammad, if you need kingdom, we're going to make you a king over us. If you need leadership, you'll be our leader. If you need a doctor, or you're struggling with, you know, insanity, or struggling with possession or sihr, we're going to bring you the best experts. You know, if you, whatever you want of dunya, we're going to offer you and give you. But you have to, you know, give up, and you have to stop what are you, you're coming with of this da'wah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was listening, giving attentive ears to the people. It's an incident in Sirah. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Afaraghta ya Abul Walid? Have you finished your speech? Do you have anything else to add? Would you like to add?" You, subhanallah, it's a lesson of dialogue and how the Prophet ﷺ was opening his heart, you know, open-minded, was listening to the people. He wasn't fanatic, he wasn't harsh, alayhi salatu wasalam, a lesson of da'wah for all of us. So what did the Prophet ﷺ do? The Prophet ﷺ didn't argue. He recited Surah Fussilat from Hameen up to the Sajda. And then, subhanallah, Abu al-Walid, that person who came to negotiate with the Prophet, when he left the Prophet, subhanallah, his face was like affected by Noor. And when he went back to the people or the mushrikeen, they said, his face has changed. And he was about to believe, subhanallah al-Malik. But subhanallah, it was the insincerity or the blame for people, the bad company of people. Subhanallah, he didn't continue on his mission. So Surah Fussilat begins with Hamim, and then Tanzilun min ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, revelation from the most merciful, the entirely merciful, the especially merciful. And then Fussilat ayatuh, this is a book whose verses are clarified, are explained in detail. And then subhanallah ajib, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions here that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam Muhammad was a bashar, he was a human being. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions as well that woe to those who don't give zakah for themselves by tawheed, and they don't pay the zakah. And then Allah give us a description about the creation, the story of Genesis, or the creation of the earth, the creation of mountains, the creation of seasons, and the creation of the skies and heavens. Then a warning to the disbelievers, and giving example to those disbelievers, giving example of the people, the nation of Ad and the nation of Thamud. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions a reality that in the day of judgment, people's ears, eyes, skin are going to bear witness against the people. Then subhanAllah, beautifully from verses 30 up to 38. Beautiful ayat. I love this ayat. The ayat about istiqamah. The ayat about istiqamah. Immediately before this ayat, before 30, verse number 30, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that the disbelievers would try to push people away from listening to the Quran, because if people listen to the Quran and get the message, even subhanAllah, if they don't understand the language, but because, subhanAllah, there is some sort of, you know, guidance. Then Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. Allah speaks about those who recognize Allah as the Lord and they confess that you're proud of that, and then they have istiqama, consistency. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that the angels will support them in dunya, in their deathbed, and in the hereafter. Allah speaks about وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَالَ مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهُ, who is best in speech than a person who invites people to Allah. وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, you know, and he or she is announcing his identity, you know, identity of being of the Muslims. Be proud of that. And then subhanallah, to the rest of this ayat, and we have got the sajda when the Prophet ﷺ made sujood alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions as well, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in this ayat that the Quran is a shifa. The Quran قل هو بل هو آيات بين في الشفاء. The Quran is a healing for those who believe, and it is a deafness of ears, it is a blindness of eyes for those who don't believe. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who believe, and open our ears and hearts and eyes to the truth and the light of the Quran. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Thank you.